Hey everyone, sending you best wishes on this amazing day. Yes guys, it's 10th October and we all are celebrating World Mental Health Day. So guys, as I always say, it's all about your healthy mind first and then comes a healthy body. Being a fitness instructor for so many years, and you know that I think some of you already know it, that I specialize into being a Zumba instructor and education specialist as well. So many people come to the classes where I'm teaching regular Zumba classes online in the studio right now. They all say that, hey, you know what, Shraddha, I'm not able to build up my mindset so that I can start a healthy lifestyle, right? It can be through fitness classes, it can be with healthy meal lifestyle or diet or, you know, food lifestyle or nutrition. So it always starts with your healthy mind first. Please remember that. But on this day, I would say World Mental Health Day, what the message I want to give all of you is, the way we work out our group of muscles, let it be your cardio muscle, let it be your, that is your heart, let it be your cardio muscle, let it be your other group of muscles, the way you work it out so that you get your lean body mass or you lose fat or you want to gain muscle, whatever that, we are not going to talk about how to gain muscle or lose fat today, but the way you work out your body so that you get into that lean body mass, you also have to work on your mental strength. It doesn't just happen in one day that, hey, you know what, I just meditated today and I'm mindful today and that's it. My mental strength is amazing. So you need to work regularly every day your mental body, I would say your mind. You need to practice. It can be through your meditation, it can be through positive thinking, it can be through so many other ways, right? So I am today going to share some of the ways how I have been working on my mental health. Maybe since I remember it's been almost 2 to 3 years I do this practice, and believe me, today I feel that I am so positive about everything in my life. I am so energetic about everything in my life. I am so happy most of the time that everything I do that makes me happy, or I do everything that makes me happy, right? So mental health, mental fitness is one of the most crucial thing which has been, I would say, not aware of something, but yes, we all are aware, but we don't practice enough. In fact, today's, and I would say this year's 2021 World Mental Health Day theme is also about how the world is into unequal mental health. How many of us, we really practice mental fitness every day? So let me share some of the things that I did since last 2 to 3 years, and I hope this will help you, or maybe you can just give it a try if this can help you. So I practice mental fitness every day with a meditation. So no, I don't meditate guys for 20 minutes or 10 minutes, close my eyes and I just focus and trying to empty my mind. No, that's not my kind of meditation. I do meditation with guided affirmations. I get up in the morning and I start with gratitude affirmations. I'm always thankful about what things, you know, maybe just 5 things, list of 5 things I make. And in the beginning, I used to keep the list under my pillow. I get up in the morning and I just read it. For the first few days, few weeks, it didn't make any sense. But then I started feeling it that, yeah, this is exactly. And I used to look forward for this gratitude or affirmations that were really making me happy. I don't know why, but that really made me happy. So I practice through affirmations. So you can pick up also affirmations like, for example, if you feel that, you know, I'm not enough, I always doubt myself, I'm not confident enough, write it down, whatever these 2 to 3 things or 5 things that you like, that I am the best, I am confident, I am enough, I do everything what makes me happy, I am happy. Whatever things you think that I need to work on more, make those note of, you know, just list down the things and just say it every day. That can be one way, just the way I do it, like your guided affirmations. And yes guys, this is a meditation. Even though you meditate for 1 minute or 2 minutes, 5 minutes, you can still do it. So that's one way. And the second thing that I want to share is, guys, since 2 to 3 years, what I have started doing is, see, your mind, a human mind, guys, attracts negativity just like that. Why? I don't know, but it attracts negativity, and this is the way human minds have been there always, guys. So let's not go and change that. This is what it is. Now, to make it positive, I know the struggle is more, But for that, you just have to train your conscious mind. And to train the conscious mind, you have to start training your subconscious mind. So maybe when you know, let's say, what is conscious and subconscious. Let's say you've been into a different zone and maybe you're into different thoughts. Even though you're driving from somewhere, subconsciously you will drive to your home, right? Because you know, your brain knows the path so well. So you train your mind subconsciously so well so that you can always think positive, right? So let's work on this. How I do it, I'm just going to share that thing with you. Maybe you can just give it a try and see how it works for you guys. I think it's going to work for everybody. Just give it a try. So what I do is, by end of the day, I gather all the things in my mind, what went wrong in my life today, or you know, where I have been on very low emotion sometime, or you know, if anybody was very rude enough to me or loud at me, or maybe something just went wrong with some people. It can be work, it can be family, it can be absolutely anything, guys. So what I used to do is, I used to take only one incident at a time. Now let's say I think about somebody who has been extremely rude to me. It can be my family close person, it can be my mom, it can be my spouse, it can be my daughter, it can be my best friend, anybody, or anybody at the work who can absolutely be rude to me, right? Now I think about that incident, that I was very angry when my best friend was rude to me. She shouted at me and she said something loudly, and the first reaction was that made me angry, right? And that's absolutely normal, guys. That's the first emotion. That reaction, that emotion comes out, that you are very upset because somebody disrespects you, and you're like, hey, you know, why are you being rude to me? Now what I do is, I take that incident, I think about it by end of the day, and I change into a different situation. I tell myself, maybe my friend was having a bad day. Maybe she was already upset on something that she just, you know, kind of reacted back to me, or just banged on me saying that, hey, blah, 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 or anything like that. I'll try to add more compassion, more empathy by end of the day, right? I know that's not going to change the situation. Of course not. We cannot just go back to the time and change it. Yes, when she was upset on me, I showed her anger by saying, why are you angry at me? For no reason. I don't care, or whatever it is. We had a fight maybe. But by end of the day, I started changing it. Now, practice these kind of situations every day. By end of the day, just take one situation and convert it into a different perspective. Look at a different perspective. First, your mind is going to object. Your mind is going to say, no, you know, why should I lose my respect? Why? It's okay, I'm angry and I'm upset. That's okay. But the anger, being upset, being low on energy, it's not going to take you anywhere. It's not about your friend. It's not about your closed one who was, I would say, upset on you or who made you feel horrible. It was you who suffered the most, right? Because you gave out an emotion which was sucking your energy. So try to have a different perspective for these kind of situations. Now, I've been doing this for more than 2 to 3 years. And now today, if something goes wrong in my work, something goes wrong at my family, or my, you know, it can be my closed friends, my relatives, I don't get, I would say, I wouldn't say that I don't get hurt much. Of course, you know, we are attached to people, so we do get hurt, but I would still be in a positive mindset to handle that situation. So I'm not affected so much about it. My energy doesn't go low. And this is the way. Today, after 2 to 3 years, my mind subconsciously reacts to the situation positively. So practice these situations every day, guys, and start working on your mental health every day. Just the way, let's say if you have a blood pressure problem, or if your lifestyle is too much sedentary, and if you have joint issues or anything, you are going to start exercising. Maybe you'll start with a yoga class, or maybe you'll start with a Zumba class, or maybe you'll just join my class for a Zumba, right? So you have to start, and then maybe after 3 weeks, you're going to come to me and you'll say, you know what, Shweta, my stamina has got better because I'm coming to your Zumba class for last 3 weeks. But does it mean that after 3 weeks, your stamina has got good? Now you're going to hold on to your stamina and you're not going to practice your cardio? No, it's about practicing every day. It's one day, practice every day, one day at a time, and only then you're going to progress in your physical fitness. The same way you're going to progress with your mental fitness, your mental health. Every day gets better if you practice it every day. So guys, focus on your mental health so much. If your mind is strong enough, believe me, your physical health is just going to change like that. So guys, again sending you a lot of best wishes on this. I love this day, guys. This has been a very much important day, I would say, to me, a very vital day of my life. Wishing you, or sending you, best wishes on this World Mental Health Day.